Well, as I mentioned before, tomorrow is Dragon Boat Festival.
就像我之前说的，明天就是那个端午节。
Now, Dragon Boat Festival is the time of year where people do Dragon Boat racing and eat sticky rice dumplings.
端午节呢是一个你会看到呢很多人去赛龙舟，然后吃粽子的一个日子。
Let's say this together, shall we?
我们一起来说好不好
？Dragon Boat.
Dragon Boat.
Dragon Boat.Listen to kind of, don't listen to me. And sticky rice dumplings.
Sticky rice dumplings.
Good.
Jones.
Yeah, very good. Okay. Well, if you don't know what sticky rice dumpling is, we'll be having a lot of that after today's service.
如果你不知道粽子是什么的话呢，在今天我们崇拜结束，在午餐的时候，你就会知道它是到底是什么。
And I'm really excited because that's my favorite, one of my favorite dishes.
长谦他非常兴奋，因为对他来说，这是他其中一个特别喜欢吃的一个东西。
But for those who don't know, the story behind Dragon Boat Festival, I have a video for you guys.
但是对那些可能对那个端午节不了解的一些弟兄姐妹呢，我预备了一个视频给大家看。
This video is in English, but there is Mandarin subtitles.
对，这个视频呢，影片是用英文播放，但是它有那个中文的那个字幕。
So enjoy.
Do you know how the Dragon Boat Festival came about? Let me tell you more about the legend. A long, long time ago, there was a great boy named Chu Yan. He was born into a ruling family in Kingdom Chu. Chu Yan became the number one counselor and minister of the kingdom. During the warrior's days, Chu Yan warned King Chu about the threats from Kingdom Chu. However, King Chu ignored Chu Yan and some of the officials were jealous.They took the opportunity to dismiss and exile Chu Yan. Chu Yan helplessly watched his motherland decline in the hands of corrupted statesmen. Soon enough, Kingdom Chu was defeated by Kingdom Jin. King Chu was caught and sent into the dungeon by King Jin. 3 years later, King Chu passed away in the kingdom.Upon hearing Kingdom Chu's defeat and King Chu's death, Chu Yan was driven to great despair. On the fifth day of the fifth month, he committed suicide in the Milo River. The locals rushed out to the river in boats to find Chu Yan's body. They threw stuffed rice and bamboo stems and eggs into the river to prevent the dragon in the river and other fishes from eating Chu Yan's body. A Chinese doctor poured Ryalga wine into the river to poison the dragon. Eventually, a drug dragon floated on the surface of the river. Remains of Chu Yan's clothes could be seen on the dragon. The locals eventually captured and killed the dragon.Is formed. Locals will raise their boats, eat rice dumplings, and drink Ryalga wine on the fifth day of the fifth lunar month in commemoration of the great poet Chu Yan.
All right, so now you all know the story behind Dragon Boat Festival.
现在你们都知道了端午节背后的故事了吧？
Certainly is a touching story, isn't it?
这当然是一个很感人的故事，不是吗？
Of a man's loyalty, unwavering loyalty to his nation.
这讲述了一个男人对他祖国坚定不移的他的忠诚。
But let's pause and reflect.
但让我们静下心来反思一下。
How many of you think Chu Yan's death was worth it?
在座的有多少人认为屈原的死是值得的呢？
Let's take a poll.
我们现在来做个民意调查。
Who here believes he did a noble thing in sacrificing his life?
有谁呢？在座的有谁认为他的牺牲是高尚的？
A few, one, okay. A few, all right. Who here thinks he shouldn't have done that?
谁认为他不应该这么做？
A few, and the rest of you are, what, maybe not sure?
可能剩余的可能就不知道。
Look, it is a tough question, and there's no right answer.
这个没有对错。
Okay, we all may have different opinions about this.
我们可能每个人都有不同的见解。
But ultimately, it all comes down to whether you think what he died for was worth it.
那归根结底的话呢，这要看你认为他为之牺牲的事是否是真的值得。
Is it really worth it to give up your life for a government that no longer exists?
为一个不复存在的政府去牺牲值得吗？
For me personally, I don't think it was worth it.
对我来说，我认为并不值得。
Because what about his family?
因为他的家人会怎么办呢？
You know, what about the people who are still living there?
为那些还活着的人怎么办呢？
If I was Xu Yan, I would have gone back to my homeland.
如果我是屈原的话，我会选择回到祖国。
To help rebuild the country so that the people who still live there can have better lives.
去帮助呢重建那个国家，然后让继续生活在那里的人们过上更好的生活。
Well, about 300 years later, there was another man who died for the people.
大约在300年以后呢，有另外一个人为到的人牺牲了他自己。
In contrast to Xu Yan, however, he did not die out of despair.
然而呢，与屈原不同的是，他并没有死于绝望。
Rather, he died out of love.
反而他是因爱而死。
And today, billions of people worship him.
如今呢，有世界上数十亿万计的人呢，都来在敬拜、崇拜他。
Not because of his patriotism, but because of the hope and eternal life that he brought to the world.
并不是因为他的爱国主义，而是因为他可以带给世界的那有希望和永生。
His name is.
他的名字是
Jesus.
Yes.
Yes. 2,000 years ago, God sent His one and only Son to die on the cross for us.
在2000多年前呢，耶稣神差遣他的唯一的儿子耶稣基督来为我们死在十字架上。
Why did Jesus give up his life for us?
为什么耶稣会为了我们牺牲他自己的生命呢？
Because it was worth it.
因为他认为是值得的。
His sacrifice brought salvation to all of humanity.
他的牺牲为全人类带来了拯救。
Let us look at what Jesus said in Matthew chapter 16, verse 21 to 23.We'll read this slide in English and the next slide in Mandarin.
我们用英文来读，然后大家看中文的字幕。
From that time on, English speakers, Jesus began to explain to his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things at the hands of the elders, the chief priests, and the teachers of the law, and that he must be killed and on the third day be raised to life. Okay, 普通话。
现在用国语。彼得就拉着他，劝他说：“主啊，万不可如此，这事必不临到你身上。”耶稣转过来对彼得说：“撒旦，退我后边去吧，你是绊我脚的，因为你不体贴神的意思，只体贴人的意思。”
Notice today's passage begins a very important phrase.
我们要留意今天的这个经文呢，是用一个很重要的词开始的。
From that time on，
就是从此。
This is a temporal marker that signals a transition in Jesus' ministry。
这是一个时间的标记，标志着耶稣事工的一个转变。
Because prior to that moment, Jesus had been teaching his disciples who he is。
因为在这个之前呢，耶稣呢一直呢都在教他的门徒。是教导他的门徒说他到底是谁。
And the climax of that is earlier in verse 16, where Jesus had asked his disciples, "Who do you say?"
然后高潮呢，就是在今天经文的第十六节，在那里耶稣问他们说：“你们说我是谁？”
And Peter replies, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the Living God."
然后使徒彼得回答说：“你是基督，是永生神的儿子。”
Now this is a pivotal moment.In the Gospel of Matthew, because this is the first time that the disciples recognized Jesus to be the Messiah.
那这是一个就是马太福音中一个关
save God's people and establish an eternal kingdom on earth.
就是旧约先知所预言的那位将拯救神的子民，并在地上建立一个永恒国度的那个神所拣选的那一位。
So it's interesting that straight after Jesus, Peter recognizes Jesus to be the Messiah, what does Jesus do?
然后有趣的是呢，在彼得承认耶稣是主，是基督之后，他耶稣做了什么呢？
He goes and tells them that he's going to die.
然后他接着告诉他们，他快要死了。
Notice the word that Jesus used.
请留意耶稣所使用的字。
He must.
他说他必须。
Not he might or he should.
而不是说他可能吧，或者是应该。
He must go to Jerusalem to be killed.
他必须上耶路撒冷去被杀害。
The word must tells us that Jesus' death was not an accident.
这个必须在这里就告诉我们，耶稣的死并不是一个偶然。
It was not a misfortune.
也不是一个不幸。
It was part of God's plan. From the very beginning.
而是从一开始就是神的一个计划。
It was the reason why he came to earth.
这就是他来到世上的一个原因。
With this statement, Jesus links his identity as the Messiah to his mission.
那透过这一句话呢，耶稣将他这个基督的身份与他的使命联系了在一起。
His mission was to die for humanity.
他的使命就是为人类而死。
Jesus' reply, however, shocks the disciples.
那耶稣的，然而耶稣的回答呢，使到了门徒们都非常的惊叹。
They could not believe that the Messiah would really be killed.
他们不敢相信，一位基督弥赛亚真的会被杀害。
Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him.
然后彼得就把耶稣拉到一边，就开始了训斥他。
Never, Lord, this shall never happen to you.
他说主啊。这事并不临到你身上。
Isn't it ironic that straight after making perhaps the greatest confession in the Bible, here we see Peter rebuking Jesus?
在做出了圣经中也许是最伟大的这个忏悔之后，我们在这里看到彼得责备耶稣，这难道不具有这个讽刺的意味吗？
He obviously did not think Jesus' death.
他显然认为耶稣的死是不值得的。
He tries to stop Jesus from dying.
他在尝试的去阻止那个耶稣被杀害。
Because the kind of Messiah that Peter envisioned when he made that confession was not the kind of Messiah that Jesus really was.
因为彼得在告解时所设想的那个基督，并不是耶稣这样的一个基督。
The Jews expected the Messiah to be a mighty king.
犹太人所期望的那个基督弥赛亚就是一位强大的君王。
Someone strong and powerful who would overthrow the Romans and restore Israel's glory as a nation.
他们所设想的那一个是一位强壮有力的人，一个君王，而且他能推翻罗马人的统治。
Not someone who would suffer persecution, rejection, and death.
而不是呢一个会遭受迫害。拒绝和死亡的人。
Today there are many people who also find it hard to accept that God would allow His Son to die.
今天呢，在很多世界上也很多人很难去接受，就是神允许他的儿子去被处死的这件事情。
The religion of Islam, for example, also believes that Jesus was the Messiah.
例如伊斯兰教也相信耶稣，他也是基督弥赛亚。
But they do not believe that he was crucified.
但是他们不相信耶稣被钉十字架。
Instead, they believe that just before he got crucified, God replaced Jesus with someone else who resembles him.
相反呢，他们相信呢，在耶稣被钉那个十字架之前，神用另一个与他相似的人去取代了他。
Because the idea of a God who suffers and dies is unfathomable to Muslims.
因为对于穆斯林人来说，教徒来说呢，神受苦受难并死去的这个想法是不可以理解的。
There are many people today who like Peter.
今天有很多像彼得这样的人。
They want a Christianity without the cross.
他们想要一个没有十字架的基督教。
But God's ways are higher You are a stumbling block to me. You do not have in mind the concerns of God, but merely human concerns.
在今天经文的第二十三节里面，在这里耶稣斥责彼得说：“撒旦，退我后边去吧！你是绊我脚的，因为你不体贴神的意思，只体贴人的意思。”
You see, people who see things from a human point of view can never understand why God would die for His people.
当你看到那些只从人的角度的看问题的人，永远呢就是无法去理解神为何要为他的子民而死。
But God's way to victory is through the cross.
但是神他去要去战胜的一个路途一个方式，就是要通过十字架。
Jesus defeated the devil by coming not as a conquering king, but rather as a suffering servant who laid down his life for the people.
我们的耶稣他战胜了那个恶者，不是通过他是一个非常高高在上的一个君王，而是一个非常谦卑的，作为一个仆人的方式来战胜了这个君王这个恶者黑暗的势力。
For how else could God empathize with how struggles if He Himself did not go through suffering?
如果我们的神没有亲自去经历这个苦难的话，他如何可以真的体会到我们人类所经历的每一个苦难呢？
How could God remove our sins if He Himself did not bear our sins?
如果我们的神他没有去为我们承担我们的罪的话，他怎么可以来将我们的罪一一的去抹去呢？
How can there be a resurrection if there is no death?
如果没有耶稣的死的话，怎么会有复活呢？
If you find it hard to believe that Jesus died at the cross for you, it's because you do not have in mind the concerns of God, but merely human concerns.
如果你很难相信，就是耶稣为你死在十字架上的话，那是因为你的心中没有神的忧虑，而只有人类的一些。
Those who set their mind on the things of God, however, recognize two profound truths about the cross.
然而，那些把心思放在神的事上的人，会意识到十字架上的两个真理。
The first truth is, you are worth dying for.
首先，就是你值得耶稣为你而死。
Yes, the amazing truth of the gospel is that Jesus came all the way down from heaven.
是的，福音令人惊叹。耶稣他从天堂远道而来，然后为你而死。
That is how precious you are to God.
你对神来说就是这么的宝贵。
You are worth the life of His one and only Son.
你值得他唯一的儿子耶稣基督，他为你舍命。
1 John chapter 4 verse 9 says, This is how God showed His love among us. He sent His one and only Son into the world that we might live through Him.
在约翰一书的第四章第九节里面说到，神差他的独生子到世间来，使我们借着他得生。神爱我们的心在此就显明了。
If you want to know how much God loves you, look no further than the cross.
如果你想知道神有多么的爱你，你就不要往其他的方面看，就看十字架就够了。
Consider what Jesus Christ went through for you.
你要去思考耶稣基督为你所经历的一切。
He was beaten and whipped.
他被殴打，而且被鞭打。
He was falsely accused, mocked, and slandered and ridiculed.
他被诽谤、被诬告和嘲笑。
Nails were hammered through his hands and feet.
钉子穿过他的手和脚。
And as he hung up there on that cross.It was your sins that held him there.
当他被挂在那十字架上的时候，就是你的罪把他钉在了那里。
Jesus could have easily escaped the crucifixion if he wanted to.
如果耶稣他愿意的话，他可以轻易的逃脱钉十字架这样的事情。
But he willingly went up to the cross because he knew that was the only way he could save you.
但是他心甘情愿的去走向十字架。因为他知道这是他能拯救你的唯一的方法。
A few years ago, archaeologists uncovered in the Chinese province of Qinghai two 4,000-year-old skeletons of a mother and a child.
在几年前呢，考古学家在中国青海省呢，发现了两具 去啊，距今四千年的母子的骸骨。
It is believed that both of them perished during a devastating earthquake that happened around 2000 BC.
那据说呢，他们都是在那个西元前的两千年的一场大地震中呢上升的。
And remarkably, their bodies were so well preserved that you could see what the mother was doing in her final moments.
令人惊讶的是，他们的尸体呢保存得如此的完好，以至于你可以看到母亲在最后的时刻在做些什么。
Can you see what she's doing?
你可以看到她做了什么吗？
She was draping her arms around her child in a vain attempt to shield him from the earthquake.
她用双臂抱着她的儿子，试图让孩子免于地震的伤害。
That is a picture of what Jesus Christ did for us.
这就是耶稣基督在十字架上为我们所做的一切的一个图像。
He shielded you from God's judgment by offering his body as an atoning sacrifice.
他以他自己的身体作为赎罪祭来保护你去免受神的审判。
He bore your sins so that your sins can be forgiven.
他承担了你的罪，使你的罪得到宽恕。
He laid down his life for you so that you can be redeemed from the penalty of death.
为你舍命，从你使你呢从死亡的刑罚中可以得着救赎。
That is how valuable you are to God.
这就是你对神的价值。
You are worth dying for.
你值得他为你而死。
You are worth all the pain, agony, and humiliation and shame that Jesus endured at the cross.
你值得耶稣在十字架上忍受所有的痛苦、折磨和羞耻，因为他是如此的爱你。
Because he loves you so, so.
因为他是如此如此的爱你。
Maybe that is the first time that someone has ever said that to you, that you are worth it.
也许这是有人第一次对你说你值得。
Maybe all your life you've had people say to you, "Oh, you're a failure."
也许在你的一生中，有人都对你说你就是一个失败者。
You're a disappointment.
你是一个让人失望的人。
You're not worth my time.
不值得，不配得我的时间。
You'll never amount to anything in life.
你一辈子都不会有出息。
But that is not how God sees you.
但是这不是神这样看你的。
If you ever doubt your worth or question how much you are loved,
如果你曾经怀疑过自己的价值，或怀疑过自己被爱的程度，那请你看看十字架。
Remember what Christ went through for you.
你要记得基督他为了你去经历了什么。
Because in God's eyes, you are worth dying for.
因为在神的眼里，你是值得他为你而死的。
You are cherished beyond measure.
你被真爱的无以复加。
And there is nothing that God is not willing to sacrifice in order to bring you back to Him.
为了把你带回他的身边，没有任何的事是神不愿意去为你牺牲的。
The question is, what is Jesus worth to you?
问题是，耶稣对你来说有什么价值？
That brings us to the second profound truth about the cross.
这就把我们带到了关于十字架的第二个真理。
It not only demonstrates that you are worth it, but Jesus is worth dying for.
十字架的这真理不单是显示了你值得耶稣为你而死，也显示了我们都值得为耶稣而死。
Let us look at what Jesus went on to say in verses 24 to 27.
我们来看看耶稣在十字架上经历些什么。
We'll first read it in Mandarin.
我们先用那个普通话来读。于是耶稣对门徒说：“若有人要跟从我，就当舍己，背起他的十字架来跟从我。因为凡要救自己生命的，必丧掉生命。”
English, what good will it be for someone to gain the whole world yet forfeit their soul? Or what can anyone give in exchange for their soul? For the Son of Man is going to come in his Father's glory with his angels, and then he will reward each person according to what they have done. Now in these verses, Jesus spells out the demands of being his disciple.
那在这几节经文里面呢，耶稣他阐述了身为门徒的一些要求。
How do you know if you are really a follower of Jesus?
你如何知道自己是一位真正的耶稣的跟随者呢？
What is the difference between a
在假基督徒和真基督徒之间有什么样的区别呢？
Well, there are three requirements that you must meet if you want to be Jesus' disciple.
如果你想成为耶稣基督他的门徒的话呢，就有三个你需要去满足的要求。
The first requirement is denial.
第一个条件就是你要舍己。
Jesus said, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves.
耶稣说，若有人要跟从我，就当舍己。
Now when Jesus talks about denying yourself, he's not talking about denying a chocolate bar. I find that very hard to do, hard to say.
当耶稣在这里谈到舍己的时候呢，他说的并不是说舍弃啊一块巧克力。
Or denying yourself a nice vacation.
也不是说啊舍弃去享受一个美好的假期。
He's not talking about what many Christians do during the season of Lent, where you deny eating or doing certain things.
他说的这个舍己呢，也不是像许多基督徒呢在四旬斋期间所做的那样。
Rather, the word in the original language means to disown yourself.
相反，这个字呢，在原文中的字面意思就是要否认自己。
It's the same word that is used of Peter when he denied Christ three times.
彼得三次不认耶稣基督时，也用过这个词。
What Jesus is talking about here is not denying things for yourself, but rather.
耶稣在这里所说的啊，不是说舍弃自己的事。
But rather deny yourself.
而是要舍己。
Deny your right to run your own life.
要去剥夺你掌控自己人生的权利。
It means to make Jesus the Lord of your life, so that He gets to call all the shots.
这呢就意味着让耶稣成为你生命的主宰，然后让他去发号施令。
In other words, to deny yourself is to reject the worldly philosophy of self-importance.
换句话说呢，舍己呢就是拒绝主导我们当今文化的自我重要性。
Self-indulgence,
自我放纵。
Self-fulfillment,
自我实现。
Self-sufficiency,
自给自足。
And selfish living that dominates our culture today.
和自私自利的这种世俗哲学。
The second requirement is death.
第二个要求就是死亡。
You must pick up the cross.
你必须背起十字架。
Now today many people wear a cross on their neck.
今天呢有很多人呢会在他们的脖子上戴上一个十字架。
But in the first century, the cross was not a pretty piece of jewelry.
但在第一世纪呢，十字架并不是一件很漂亮的首饰。
Nor was it an icon that you stick on top of the church like those.
也不是说在教堂顶上的那种这么漂亮的那种标志。
Rather, it was an instrument of torture and death.
反而它是一种很酷刑和死亡的工具。
Imagine wearing an electric chair around your neck.
你可以想象一下，你的脖子上挂着一张电椅。
Because that was what it was.
因为那十字架，那就是十字架。
It was a barbaric form of capital punishment that the Romans used to execute the worst criminals.
那是一种非常野蛮的死刑的形式，是罗马人用来呢去处决最恶劣的罪犯的一种方式。
They would put the cross on their back and march them down the street as a public spectacle.
他们会把十字架呢挂在罪犯的背上，然后让他们在大街上游行，然后以示公开。
And then they would attach the person onto the cross by driving nails through their hands and feet.
然后他们会用钉子去穿过罪犯的手和脚。
And then leave them up there until they slowly suffocate to death.
然后他们就把他们留在那个十字架上，然后呢就让他们在那直到窒息而死。
It is estimated that the Romans crucified about 3,000 people during Jesus' lifetime.
据估计呢，在基督的一生中，罗马人定过大约三万人在十字架上。
30,000.
大约三万人。
So when Jesus talks about taking the cross, all the disciples would have known exactly what Jesus meant by it.
因此呢，当耶稣谈到背起十字架时，他所有的门徒都会完全明白耶稣的意思。
It meant death.
那意味着死亡。
It meant suffering.
那意味着受苦。
It meant humiliation.
那意味着羞辱。
Dietrich Bonhoeffer in his book The Cost of Discipleship said, When Christ calls a man, He bids him come and die.
潘霍华在他的著作《做门徒的代价》这本书里面说到，当基督呼召一个人，他是召他来为他死。
Let's say this together in English and Mandarin, shall we?
我们一起用中文来读，好不好？
When Christ calls a man, he bids him come and die. You know, what a quote, right?
这是多么多么的一个棒的一个句话。
Dietrich Bonhoeffer literally did eventually die for Christ when he was executed by the Nazis during the World War II.
潘霍华呢，他最终呢，的确呢，在第二战的期间呢，被纳粹处决，为基督而死。
And this continues to happen for many of our brothers and sisters around the world who live in countries where Christians are persecuted.
这对于生活在我们基督徒受迫害国家的世界各地的基督徒的许多弟兄姐妹来说，这种情况呢，其实仍在发生。
For the rest of us, the cross that we need to bear may not be physical death.
但对我们其余的人来说呢，我们需要背负的十字架可能并不是肉体上的死亡。
But death to self.
而是向自我的死亡。
Putting to death my life of self and beginning a life of selfless sacrifice and service to our Lord Jesus Christ.
放下我的自我的生命，然后开始为我们的主耶稣基督无私奉献和侍奉的生命。
For some of you, to take up your cross may mean that you abandon your personal ambition or personal desires to pursue God's calling for your life.
然后对你们中的一些人来说，背起十字架可能意味着放弃个人的野心或个人的愿望，去追求神对你生命的呼召。
For some of you, may mean rejection or a mistreatment from others because of your faith.
对你们中的一些人来说，这可能意味着因为信仰而遭到他人对你的拒绝和虐待。
For some of you, may mean sacrificing your job, sacrificing your finances, sacrificing even your family and friends for the sake of the gospel.
对你们中的一些人来说，这可能意味着为了福音而牺牲自己的工作、经济，或牺牲自己的家人或朋友。
The third requirement is devotion.
第三个要成为基督耶稣的门徒的需要的那个要求，就是要尽心献给耶稣。
They must deny themselves, take up their cross, and what? Follow me.
他们必须舍己，背起他的十字架来做什么？来跟随他。
Now here, this is not talking about following someone on WeChat Moments or Facebook.
耶稣在这里所说的，并不是说在微信朋友圈上，或者是那个脸书上去追踪某人。
You know, it's more than merely checking up on someone when you're free.
那这不仅仅呢是有空的时候就查看人，或随时了解有关他的一些新闻。
Keeping up to date with a bit of news about that person, rather the original word is akolotheo.
相反呢，那个原词呢就是 akolotheo.
It literally means to move behind someone and follow their lead.
它的字面意思呢就是说走在某个人的后面 ，OK， 并愿意。去跟随他们的领导。
It means that you take the same role as that person.
那意思就是说和那个人就是走同一条路。
Now in ancient times, discipleship was more like an apprenticeship.
在古代的时候呢，门徒更像是学徒。
You would follow the guy around.
你会跟随着这个人。
Watch what he did.
然后观察他做了些什么。
And copy him.
然后并模仿他。
Discipleship in those days was more than a transfer of information.
在那个时代，当时的那个门徒不仅仅呢是信息的一个传递，而是一次彻底的一个改变。
Rather, it was a total transformation.
而且是一次彻底的转变。
The goal was to become more like your master.
那个目标呢，就是要成为像你主人一样的人。
Christian discipleship then is inviting Jesus.To be part of your everyday activities.
那么基督徒门徒培训就是邀请耶稣参与你生命中的每项的活动。
You don't just visit Jesus at church on Sundays.
你不会只是在星期天去教会去拜访他。
You don't just hang out with him for one hour.
你不只是呢就是和他玩一个小时。
You don't just go to him when you need help.
当你也不只是说当你需要帮助的时候才去找他。
You take him everywhere you go.
无论你走到哪里，你都会带着他。
You do life with him.
你会跟他一起去生活。
That's the difference between a spectator and a follower.
这就是旁观者和跟随者的区别。
You know, spectators come for only a short visit.
旁观者呢，只是来做一个短暂的一个参观。
They'll serve from the sidelines.
他们从旁观者的角度呢去观察。
But stop short of making any personal commitments or changes to their life.
但是呢，他们不会做出任何个人的承诺或改变自己的生命。
A follower, however, participates in the life of Jesus.
而跟随者则参与耶稣的生命。
They integrate Jesus' teachings into every aspect.
他们将耶稣的教导融入他们生命的各个的层面。
And embrace the call to deny yourself, take up the cross, and follow Jesus.
而且他们会接受去舍己，背起十字架，然后跟随耶稣的呼召。
Are you a spectator?
你是一位旁观者，还是一位跟随者？
Do you invite Jesus to be part of your everyday activities?
你邀请耶稣成为你日常活动的一部分吗？
Do you invite him to work?
你会邀请他来工作当中吗？
Do you invite him to your home?
你会邀请他来你的家里吗？
Do you take him with you when you go on vacation?
当你去度假的时候，你会带他一起去吗？
Do you take him with you when you go see your friends and family?
当你去见你的家人朋友的时候，你会带他一起去吗？
Is there any place you go?Any activity or anything you watch that you'll be embarrassed to take Jesus with you?
你有没有任何的地方、任何的活动，或者是你所观看到的任何的事情，会让你因为有耶稣在身边而感到尴尬呢？
Listen up, Jesus is not looking for spectators.
听好了，耶稣并不是在寻找观众。
He's looking for followers.
跟随者。
He's looking for people who are committed to him for the long haul.
他要找的是那些可以对他有长期承诺的人。
He's looking for people who are willing to walk with him no matter how difficult or dangerous the journey gets.
他要找的是无论旅程多么的艰难都愿意与他同行的人。
He's looking for people who are prepared to deny themselves.Die to self and devote their whole lives to follow Jesus.
他正在寻找那些准备要舍己、向自我死，并愿意去尽心奉献一生给耶稣的人。
Now you may be thinking, Apostle, you're not making a very appealing case here for becoming a Christian.
现在你可能会在想，长先传道，你说的成为基督徒的理由并不吸引人哦。
And like Peter, you may be saying, Never, Lord.It's not worth it.
你可能会像彼得一样，可能会说，不啊，主，这不值得。
And you are right.
你是对的。
It is an unappealing proposition when you look at it from an earthly perspective.
从世俗的角度来看的话，这的确呢是一个不吸引人的一个提议。
But when you look at it from an eternal perspective, it becomes more than worth it.
但是当你从永恒的一个角度来看它的时候，它就变得非常值得。
Because without the cross, there is no crown.
因为没有十字架就没有冠冕。
Without sacrifice, there is no salvation.
没有牺牲就没有救赎。
Without death, there's no life.
没有死亡就没有生命。
There are many people here today who want Christianity without the cross.
今天有很多人想要没有十字架的基督教。
They want a happy religion where God blesses you and takes away.
神祝福你，并消除你所有痛苦和磨难的宗教。
But Christianity without the cross is not real Christianity.
但没有十字架的基督教就不是真正的基督教。
It's just a cheap substitute.
而只是一个廉价的替代品。
If you want God to reward you, you must be willing to walk the way of the cross.
如果你想要神来奖赏你的话，你就必须走十字架的路。
Because that's the way of Christ.
因为那是基督的道路。
In verse 25, Jesus said, "For whoever wants to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for me will find it."
在今天经文的第25节里面说到，因为凡要救自 必丧掉生命，凡为我丧掉生命的，必得着生命。
Imagine you contract a deadly disease, and the doctor tells us that the only way to save you is to amputate that arm and replace it with a new prosthetic arm.
你想象一下啊，你的手臂感染了一个致命的疾病，那医生告诉你呢，要拯救你的唯一方法就是截肢，并换上新的假肢来代替。
How many of you would hold on to that disease arm?
你们有多少人会选择保留这个患病的这一个啊、这个手呢？
No, that's good.
很好，你们没有人会选择要。
How many of you would be willing to let the doctor cut off your disease arm and replace it with a new one?
你们当中有多少人愿意让医生啊、去去掉这个坏的手臂，然后帮你换一只新的手臂呢？
Surely the second one, right?
当然。
What's the point of holding on to a bad arm if it's going to lead you to death?
因为留着一只会导致死亡的手臂有什么好处呢？
And yet that is what many people are doing with their lives.
然而，这正是许多人的生活状况现状。
They are clinging on to what they cannot keep and missing out on the greatest treasure of all.
他们紧紧抓住自己留不住的东西不放，然后错过了最宝贵的宝藏。
The Bible says.Human race has been infected with a deadly disease called sin.
圣经上面说，整个人类都感染了一个很致命的疾病，它叫做罪。
And the only way to be saved is to get rid of your old life and receive the new life that Jesus gives.
而得救的唯一的途径就是要摆脱你的旧的生命。OK， 要接受耶稣所赐的新的生命。
What good is it to accumulate eight?
如果你的银行里 OK 累积了八位数的财富，但你死后却失去了这一切，那又有什么用呢？
What good is it to make a name for yourself if no one remembers will remember you after you're gone?
如果你死后没有人记得你的话，那你扬名立万又有何用呢？
What good is it to gain the whole world yet end up losing your soul?
你得到了全世界，却失去了自己的灵魂，又有什么好处呢？
Jim Elliot was a. Okay, next slide, please. Can someone control the slide from the back? Next slide. Jim Elliot was an American missionary who left his family and home to spread the gospel to the unreached people groups in Ecuador.
那个吉姆艾略特是一位美国的传教士，他为了向埃瓜多尔未曾听闻福音的人去传播福音。
Don't worry about the slides. Just listen to me.
Yeah. 不用看那个屏幕了，我们就听讲道就好了。
Now on January 3rd, 1956, he and five men visited the Warrarani village.
然后在那个1956年1月3号，他和五个人呢去到了那个威瓜多尔这个国家。
Now, at first, the missionary is very excited and encouraged by the positive.Encounters they had with the tribesmen there.
然后起初呢，那个这个传教士他们呢，对于那个他们去到那个村中的那个部落的积极的接触，感到非常的兴奋和鼓舞。
But a few days later, 10 tribesmen came into the village and killed all five of them.
但是几天之后呢，十名长石长矛的部落的成员来到他们的营地，杀死了。
Now you may think that this was a tragic loss of life.
你可能会认为这是一种很悲惨的生命，而且很浪费。
But because of this sacrifice, the Warrarani people were converted to Christianity.
但因为他们的牺牲，当那里的那个村庄的那边的人，他们都去相信了耶稣基督。
3 years later, Jim Elliot's wife and daughter were invited to live among those who had murdered their father and husband.
3年之后呢，那个艾略特他的妻子呢和女儿被邀请到那些杀害了他们丈夫和父亲的人中间去生活。
And many Warrarani accepted Christ because of their testimony and witness.
由于他们的见证呢，这个许多这个村庄的人呢，就将他们的生命献给了耶稣基督。
Jim Elliot may have had his life taken away too soon.
是的，这个艾略特啊，他们可能过早的失去了生命。
But in heaven, he has received an imperishable crown that will never be taken away from him.
但是在天堂，他得到了永远不会被夺走的不朽的冠冕。
In his diary, he wrote, "He is no fool who gives away what he cannot keep to gain what he cannot lose."
在他的日记当中，他是这么写道。为了获得无法失去的东西，来放弃自己无法保留的东西的人，并不傻。
Let's read together， 一起说。
我们一起来读。
He is no fool who gives away what he cannot keep to gain what he cannot lose，
并不傻。
So let me leave you with this question to think about。
所以现在让我给你留下这个问题，让你自己去思考。
If you are worth dying for， and Jesus is worth dying for。What are you living for?
如果你值得耶稣去为你而死，而且你也值得为耶稣而死的话，那你在为什么而活呢？
Are you living for what you cannot keep?
你是为了那些你没有办法去保留的东西而活吗？
Or are you living for what you cannot lose?
而是你会为那些不能失去的而活呢？
Are you merely living for a healthy retirement where you can enjoy a beautiful view for a brief moment?
你仅仅是为了健康的退休生活而活，让你享受短暂的一个美景吗？
Or are you living for a reward that will last for all eternity?
还是你是为了那永恒的奖赏而活呢？
For whoever wants to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for Jesus.
凡要救自己生命的必丧掉生命。凡为耶稣胜掉生命的，必得着生命。
Are you willing to give you away, give your life to Jesus to gain what you can never lose?
你是否愿意舍去你无法去保存的，去获得你永远无法失去的呢？
Because all the treasures that this world has to offer is nothing compared to the surpassing worth of knowing Jesus Christ.
因为与认识耶稣基督的超凡价值来相比的话。这个世上所能提供的一切珍宝都是垃圾。
What is this momentary life on earth worth compared to the eternal life that Jesus offers?
我们在这个世界上这么短暂的一个时刻生命，比起那永恒在耶稣基督里面的生命来说，哪一个更重要？
If you want to give your life to Jesus today, we're going to sing a song.
如果你今天想将你的生命交托给耶稣的话，我们将来一起唱这首歌。
And as we sing this song, you can come to the front or to the side, and so some of the leaders can pray for you and explain to you, what your decision means.
如果你希望想跟随耶稣的话，在我们唱歌的时候，我们邀请你可以来到前面，或者是到那个旁边那边去，我们待会会为你祷告。
And for the rest of us who have already made a commitment to Christ in the past, let us use this time to reevaluate our lives and rededicate ourselves to the Lord.
然后对于那些我们已经把我们的生命交托给耶稣的那些弟兄姐妹们，让我们用此刻重新的来重审我们的生命，然后看看我们可以为耶稣可以给他些什么。
What areas in your life do you need to put to death for Jesus?
我们去重新审核一下，我们在我们的生命当中，为了耶稣有哪些方面是要致死的
？You know what is the cross that you need to bear？
那有哪一个十字架是你需要去背的
？Let us deny ourselves, take up the cross, and follow Jesus.
让我们来舍己，背起十字架，并跟随耶稣。
Because who wants to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for Jesus.We'll find it.
因为凡要去救自己生命的，必丧掉生命；
凡为
耶稣丧掉生命的，必得着生命。
Let's stand and sing this famous hymn together, shall we?
我们一起起立来唱这一首很经典的一个诗歌。
Turn up the volume.
我们请那个音响把声音打开。
Thank you.
Father, we praise you.
天父，我们赞美你。
We have come forward today.
我们为所有来到前面的人感谢你。
We thank you, Lord Jesus, that you came to die for us, so that we may have eternal life.
我们感谢你，我们感谢你，你来到世上为我们而死，以致我们有永生的生命。
We thank you, Heavenly Father, that Jesus died so that we need not pay the death penalty.
天父，我们感谢你，因为耶稣的死。我们不用再付上罪的代价。
And even though the journey of a Christian may be difficult,
也许作为基督徒的这一个旅程是艰苦艰辛的。
It is worth it.
但是是值得的。
Because we have eternal life in Jesus.
因为我们在耶稣基督里有永生的生命。
We have a living hope in Him.
我们在他里面有活泼的盼望。
We have an everlasting joy and peace that can be only found in Him.
我们也只有在他的里面才能得到这个永恒不能夺去的喜乐。
And all that we give up for you, you will reward us back 10,000 times more when we meet you in heaven.
而我们所给耶稣的，耶稣将会十倍加倍的来给回我们，当他回来的时候。
I pray for those who have come forward today, or in their hearts want to accept Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior.
我为到今天走上前来，在他们心里要去接受耶稣基督做他们的生命的主宰的人祷告。
And you come into their life.
愿你的灵，愿你来到他们的生命当中。
And make them new.
来使他们成为新造的人。
Make them yours.
让他们成为你的人。
And I pray for the rest of us who may already be Christians.
我也为到所有已经是基督徒的弟兄姐妹祷告。
I pray that we will take seriously this call.
我祷告他们会严肃的去，真的是接受，去领受你的这一个呼召，就是让我们要舍己，背起十字架，并跟随你。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣的。